post a picture of that later. So you can see it all, JJLKFI, Nick Pagliocchini on Instagram, and if you want to see Tyler, go to my page, JJLKFI, because he's good and keeps himself off social media.
I'm on Twitter.
He's on Twitter, at Tyler the Wit.
That's true.
Dean Sharp gave him that.
It's W-A-R-T.
And then, all right, guys, here we go. These are the key 4th of July facts, as brought to you by Wallet Hub. So, how many billions of dollars, gentlemen, do you think Americans plan to spend on food for the 4th of July?
And 2.5.
2.5, says Nick. Tyler?
2.5 billion? I'm going to say $5 billion.
Tyler with the win, 7.7.
7.7?
Oh, yeah, people go ham.
They go ham, but honestly, if you think about it, it's not ham that they're doing. It's brisket, and it's like, oh, those are big.
Yeah, very nice.
Thank you.
Yes, well done.
Thank you. But they do big brisket, whatever. Have you guys priced brisket lately?
I stay away from brisket because I know how expensive it is.
Oh, my God.
And then you add in the prep for brisket.
Oh.
If you're going to prep it yourself, yikes.
If you've ever smoked a brisket, it takes like 18 hours.
Yeah, and you got to inject it with au jus, and you got to make sure you get the smoke on it, and a little bit of the seasoning. Oh, yeah.
That was the very first thing that I went to Corner Butcher Shop, and I bought a brisket, and they were like, are you sure you want to start with a brisket for your first time out? I was like, hell yeah! That was
dumb. Wake up call is coming for the Fork Reporter.
You know what? It kind of is. Did I wet test?
Did you do the fat trimming and everything?
Oh, yeah. They take care of that for you. Yeah, they did the fat trimming for me. All right. How many millions of hot dogs do you guys think will be eaten on this 4th of July?
85 million hot dogs.
85 Whoa. Million. All right, Nick.
I'm going to go with 10 million.
You guys have no faith in America. 150 million.
I feel like I had a lot more faith in America than Nick did.
Yeah, well, I'm not feeling super patriotic this year, but anyway.
There's like 70 million Americans, aren't there?
Well, yeah, but if you think about it, when's the last time you went to a 4th of July barbecue and didn't have, like, 2 hot dogs?
If I don't have a hot dog today, I'm calling it.
I was thinking the same thing. Nick,
see, it's a burger holiday for me. Not saying that I don't have dogs as well, but I'm just saying, is there burgers on is there a burger there?
Dogs with my dogs.
I like it. Dun-dun-dun.
That sounds like JJL's kind of, Saturday. Dogs with their dogs.
Totally.
A little different than my
brain. You have like dogs.
I have like friends.
D-A-W-G, yes.
Yeah.
I have friends. Yeah. Their names Dolly and Sophia and
Daisy. I didn't
doubt
that.
By the way, you guys, stupid offshoot here. But the best place to get burgers and dogs, in my opinion, is the Dog House.
Oh, I do like the Dog House.
And I love their sliders. Their hamburger sliders.
Can't say I've tried their burger options. I usually go there for a dog.
Oh, you guys. I'm telling you, you're missing out. Okay. I've literally gone to the Dog House and only ordered a hamburger.
They had it here, I think last year, they were doing a Dodgers promotion, and they actually brought them in studio.
Oh, I do remember that.
Yeah,
Nick, you need to be in this building with us.
You're telling me. I am not upset. Like, hey, I will be there. You just got to give me a computer and a mic, and we're
just
got
to bring a Cheez-It Crunchwrap with you.
Yeah, exactly.
Dude, oh, we got to talk about that.
We will.
Oh, okay, yeah, okay, we will. All right, we'll get through this. Let's see. I'm going to tell you it's 1.something billion. That Americans plan to spend on beer and wine. 1. What? Billion. Nick says 8.
Nick says 1.8. I'm going to go $1.4 billion.
Oh, he nailed it on that one. $1.4 billion that people are going to spend on beer and wine. Now, 2. What is how much Americans are going to spend on, let's see. this makes me laugh. First, let's start with the amount that people are going to spend on fireworks. 2. What? Nick?
6.
Tyler?
I'm going high. 2.9.
Nick with the win. 2.4.
My on that first line. Win.
Welcome to the board, Nick.
Woo!
Thanks, dude. Appreciate it.
Okay, but I like that they put this. What percent of fireworks injuries occur within 1 month of the 4th of July? I appreciate that this means 34% of fireworks injuries during the year happened not on the 4th of July.
Ooh, math. Go, Nick, go. Quick,
yeah, I was like, I'm in radio, not in mathematics.
66%?
There we go.
We're did you just say that. 66%, Tyler?
Yeah.
And Nick, you agreed?
Isn't that the math on it?
No, I don't know. I don't do math, I'm in radio.
Oh, yeah, I did.
You said 34%.
I'm an idiot.
Plus 66%. We got 100%.
Math, baby.
Yeah. I'm an idiot. All right. How many millions?
Sorry.
It's too early.
I didn't mean to laugh, Jen, but yeah, I get it. I'm right there with you. I was like, and the worst part is you said 34%. I started doing the math. Of course, Tyler's on top of it. But I was like, yeah, I'm in radio. I don't do math. Yeah. So, yeah.
I agree. Okay. What do you guys think is the value of American flags imported annually? It's between 1 and 10 million, I will say that. The value of American flags imported annually, how many million between 1 and 10 do you guys think?
I'm going high again. I'm going to say 8 million.
Okay, Nick?
9?
6.9.
Hmm.
I know. Tyler again. All right.
6.9. No, we both million.
6.9.
Yeah, we both
nine.
Busted, but still, if we're doing Price is Right Rules.
Oh, yeah. Price is Right Rules. So actually, it's only 2-1 if we're doing Price is Right Rules.
Well.
Yeah.
I'll give it to Tyler. The wit can have it.
The wit.
What a guy.
All right. Yeah. And how about this? The number of people who travel 50-plus miles from home for the 4th of July. How many million people travel 50-plus miles from home for the 4th of July?
37. I'm going to say
57
million.
Tyler? I'm going to say 37.
All right, then Nick actually gets that one because it is 47 million. You guys split it?
Look at that.
You have two and Nick has two.
I feel like I've gotten like four.
You have gotten four, but Price is Right Rules, you're always over.
But one I got right on the nose.
What you did? Does that get like a point and a half?
I'm going to have to blow this point.
Judge panel in here.
Okay, and finally, let's see. What is our last one? Because this is sort of tiebreaker. What percentage of Americans own an American flag?
63%. 72%.
Oh, we suck, America.
Is it like, it's like 40-something?
57%. Mm-hmm. Just barely over half of us.
I don't own one.
What the?
I own three. Well, so that doesn't, yeah.
You can just stick a little, you can get a dinky little flag and put out some, no. You know, like.
If I'm going to have a flag, I'm going to have a flag. I do have a flag actually from my grandfather because he served. So
that's awesome.
That technically would count.
That would definitely count.
I own one.
All right. So in this case, then, you both busted. It's a tie.
Shenanigans.
Shenanigans, boys. All right. Nick, tell us about the crunch wrap.
It was the weirdest thing ever. But it was, it was not terrible in any way, shape, or form. The problem is it did not hold up. The Crunchwrap specifically did not hold up within like 60 seconds of them giving it to me. It was mush.
Oh.
The flavor was good, but as opposed to a Crunchwrap where you've got like the tostada tortilla which is really nice and you get a different texture feel there.
Yes.
No, this was just, it tasted delicious. The Cheez-It flavor was great both on the tostada and on the Crunchwrap. But the tostada held up a little bit better. It did not look pretty in any way, shape, or form, but it was good and tasted delicious. The texture, though, on that Crunchwrap, it was kind of sad. And I'll post some pictures. I did post one picture yesterday, I think, on Twitter. But, I'll put one up. It's not so pretty.
Cheez-Its are like softer crackers. So I feel like in order for them to truly have success, they would have had to kind of go with, like, similar to what they did with the Doritos Locos, where you've got the hard...
Right.
It's the hardness, but... It's got to hold up.
You know what I think this morning shows is the level of connoisseurs the Wake Up Call crew is. We are on it, you
People
guys.
People aren't ready at 5 a.m. for this.
No, I know. I mean, honestly, it's like we're kind of like sommeliers of food
it's
around
a bargain
here.
Show. Yeah, you don't get this anywhere else at 5 o'clock.
That's right. Sure. You're welcome, people. Happy 4th of July. That's our gift to you. By the way, when I interviewed Joey Chestnut, he said that he drinks water for like 2 days before the contest. I can't remember exactly, but he expands his stomach.
Oh, yeah.
Then he eats all of that, and I asked him, I'm like, do you puke after you eat all the hot dogs? Joey Chestnut, if you guys are wondering, is the, I don't even know how many champs times around he's been at the Nathan's Hot Dog Eating Contest.
He accounts for 50% of hot dog intake on
football. I think he does. And he said, so he inflates his stomach for the first couple of days, and then he eats all the hot dogs, and then he does Pepto-Bismol, and he does not puke.
Is he a spokesperson for Pepto-Bismol?
No, but he should be.
What a missed opportunity.
Seriously. Hello, Pepto, if you're listening. Joey Chestnut. Used to have his number. Anyway, follow him on Twitter. I'm sure he can, you can reach out to him. Guys, thank you so much for playing. You know, I love my cheesy games in the morning.
Thanks, Dan.
When we come back...
Thanks for having me.
Hey, absolutely. It's time to get your best red, white, and blue garb out. Head to Huntington Beach today. There's a race. There's a festival. There's fireworks. And, of course, there's a parade. 4th of July consultant Stacey Newton from Huntington Beach 4th of July team will join us in just a few minutes to fill us in on all the fun. Let's get back to Nick Taliokini, and this time we are checking out the 110 again.
That's the truth. It's still a mess for the drive right now as you're making your way southbound right around Exposition toward Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Ongoing fatality crash investigation has all southbound lanes still shut down. A pedestrian was involved here. Your drive packed in tight as you come away from the 10. Plan ahead for the 405 southbound off the 10 or the 710 southbound off the 5. Both of those will definitely save you a bit of time this morning. Surface Street wire to the west of the 110. Plan for westbound way to Normandy or Vermont Avenue. East of the 110, you'll see a pretty much wide open drive as you're going along San Pedro Street or Central. KFI in the Sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
This report is sponsored by Blindster. Do you need new blinds or shades? Blindster.com offers custom-made blind shades and shutters shipped directly to you at prices less than big box retailers. Blindster blinds are easy to install and guaranteed to fit. Don't overpay for new blinds. Shop Blindster today and save big. Blindster.com.
This is Clay Travis. Here's what's trending from the iHeart Sports Network.
Presented by Blindster.
The Angels were swept by the Astros today. The Dodgers lost to the Padres. They gave up 4 runs in the ninth, falling 4-2. Dodgers backup catcher Austin Barnes has agreed to a 2-year contract through 2024. On the PGA Tour, JT Poston won the John Deere Classic. He finished 21 under, 3 strokes better than 2 other golfers. The win qualifies him for the Open Championship in 2 weeks. I'm Rich Johnson.
Do you need new blinds or shades? Blindster.com offers custom-made blinds, shades, and shutters shipped directly to you at prices less than big-box retailers. Blindster blinds are easy to install and guaranteed to fit. Don't overpay for new blinds. Shop Blindster today and save big. Blindster.com.
All right, the temperatures have been on this roller coaster, but when you're seeing the 90s and the triple digits, tell me that the first thing you're not thinking about is water, specifically a glass of ice-cold water. It's Jennifer, and I want to tell you about a Life Source water system. I have one, and I love it. My water doesn't taste funny anymore. It doesn't smell funny anymore. In every single faucet around the house, I have filtered, clean, delicious water. A Life Source Whole House water system uses proprietary technology. It's completely maintenance-free, and that's why Life Source is recognized as America's most recommended water system. Now, don't just take it from me, though. You can go on lifesourcewater.com. Check out testimonials from people like Amy, who says, "Can we give this company more than 5 stars? Amen, Amy. I'm with ya. So don't wait. Start your 5-star clean water experience today. And right now, today, this is the last day that Life Source Water will pay your sales tax. You can take advantage of huge savings, but again, this ends today. So act now if you can. Call Life Source Water for hydrating, delicious water from every tap. Call 800-803-2696 or visit lifesourcewater.com. 800-803-2696, Life Source Water. Taste and feel the difference.
Are you planning on selling your home? Hey, it's Dean Sharp, the House Whisperer. Can I give you some important advice? Don't throw away your home's true money-making power by settling for one of those quick cash deals or selling as is. Settling is not what we do with our most valuable asset, and it could cost you tens or even hundreds of thousands of dollars. Instead of settling, talk to the good folks at Revive Real Estate. Revive has a revolutionary renovate before listing program that maximizes the value of your home, but takes the stress out of pre-sale renovations. It's quick, it's easy, it's zero out of pocket, and on average, home sellers like you gain an additional $200,000. Let me say that again. On average, sellers gain an additional $200,000 in profit when they use Revive. There is a right way and a wrong way to sell your home. The wrong way is to settle. The right way is to talk to Revive. Get all the value out of selling your home at revive.realestate. That's revive.realestate.
Here's a little fiction masqueraded as facts. Did you know that banks don't give loan modifications just because you're paying your mortgage loan late? A lot of people believe this and have been told this, but it's wrong. I'm John Hope Bryant, the founder of Operation Hope. Let us help you negotiate with your lender in a logical way with a HUD-certified counselor for free to save your home today. Call 888-388-HOPE today or visit our website for more tips at operationhope.org.
Each week, at least one child dies from heat stroke after being left alone in a car. Often, these incidents are not a matter of neglect, but even the most responsible, loving parents are liable to forget a child in the car due to sleep deprivation, stress, or a change in routine, which can lead to fatal results. As temperatures continue to soar, take steps to ensure a child is never forgotten in a hot car. Download the Cars for Kids safety app today at carsforkids.org/safety app. Remember, that's cars with a K.
Portions of the following program were pre-recorded.
Amazon will allow Shmemexa,
hello,
to speak to you in the voice of your deceased loved one.
Somehow you have their voice.
So you need speak a into one whatever. Minute
yeah, recording. All you need, and then I can just imagine, you know, all of a sudden my mother talking to me.
No! Bill Handel.
That's the response.
Mornings from 6 to 10 on KFI.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. I have breaking news. Literally breaking news. Oh, that's horrible. Joey Chestnut broke something. His leg, his ankle, his, I don't know. But Joey Chestnut, the defender of Nathan's Coney Island Hot Dog Championship, will defend his title today on crutches. That's right. He hobbled over, got his weight taken this morning. Came out. There was a little bobble, I guess you could say, as he got up there on the old scale. But Joey, he's going for it. He doesn't care. Break be darned. It's hot dog time. It is Huntington Beach time right now. And can I just say Stacey Newton is from the Huntington Beach 4th of July team. And when we asked her what her official title was, she wrote back 4th of July consultant. Stacey, you are my new hero.
Thank you.
What a fun.
Good morning.
Good morning. What a fun job you have. Tell us what's going on in Huntington Beach today. It is always so much fun. I know the last couple of years you guys have had to modify it a little bit because of COVID, but sounds like you are back in full action today.
We are. We are back to our big parade, our full event schedule, which is great. We're actually setting up for the 5K run right now. Bleachers are going into the parade. So we're excited. We're excited to have, you know, the full event back today.
Okay, so 7 o'clock, right, is when the race starts?
Yes. The first race is at 7.
Okay, so 7 o'clock if you want to get out there. And then do people try and run so that they make sure that they're back in time for the parade?
Yeah, so there's 3 different runs. So, like, the last run will, like, end about 9:30. So most of the time people run the 5K and they find their spot to make marks on the street and watch the parade at 10.
Oh, that's perfect. How fun. And then once the parade starts at 10 o'clock, tell me about some of the floats or the entries that you have this year.
We have a lot of great, like, local nonprofits that are going to be in the parade this year. We have some sponsors, like La Crema and Deep Eddy. What else do we have? Gosh. So we don't have floats. But the float companies are going to... We have bands. We have high school bands. We have equestrian units. Yeah, it's going to be fun.
That was... You know what? There's something about a high school band in the 4th of July parade. I literally just gave myself goosebumps saying that. There is something so patriotic, so, you know, the future of America and them all working together to create this beautiful music. I don't know. I've always been super cheesy about that.
No, I love it. You know, Huntington Beach High School, they close out the parade every year. They request to be in the back. They put on, I mean, those kids are so talented.
Yes.
I have no music ability, but.
I was in band and thought it was a good idea to play the saxophone. That was stupid. I am not good.
Oh, wow.
Not good at that at all. Leave me out of the band. They literally said, do you want to play the bass drum instead? So that was me. I just walked down the street and banged a drum. Kind of makes sense for me.
Oh, that'd be fun.
Fun and super easy, let me tell you. Okay, so then after the parade today, what are the festivities like?
So we have a festival going on down here at Pier Plaza that's next to the pier. We have live music all day, and then tonight we end the event with fireworks over the ocean at 9 p.m.
Which is so awesome, and I know that this is one of the ones that people love to do because you're sitting there at the beach watching the fireworks. For me, Huntington Beach is sort of the ultimate way to spend the 4th of July in Southern California.
It's a completely different experience when you see it over the water.
Yeah.
You listen to the choreographed music, and yeah, it's definitely you have to come out and see it.
How did you guys do? Because I know that a lot of places had issues getting fireworks, or there was a shortage, or they had to pay more, that kind of thing this year. Did you guys do okay as far as, you know, getting enough fireworks for a good show?
Yeah, we're good. Soundscales is the event producer, so they've contacted the firework company early on to make sure that we secured what we needed for our show.
Oh, that's fantastic. Good. Okay, and how long does a 4th of July fireworks show last? I've been at some that are like, pew, pew, and they're over, and then others where I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't believe this is still going.
Yeah, I believe ours is about 23 minutes.
Wow, that is huge.
Yeah. It's a good show.
That is awesome. Okay, so for people who are wanting to know, is everything free today? I assume everything except the race this morning you'd have to register for.
Yeah, so you have to register for the race. You can actually still do that up till 7 o'clock. We have tier seats that are at two seats in Maine that are for sale, but the rest of the parade route is completely free. You can also watch the fireworks on the beach, which is, you know, an awesome vantage point, too. Which is free. So there's a lot of free stuff going on. We have vendors down here. Come down.
That is the ultimate way to spend the 4th of July. Nothing feels more SoCal than the 4th of July in Huntington Beach. Stacy, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Have a great morning. Good luck with everything. And I know you're going to have just a ton of fun. I can tell. This is KFI and KOSTHD2 Los Angeles, Orange County. Nick Pagliocchini. Doesn't that sound like a blast?
That was an amazing time. I cannot wait. And it's been a while since I've been out to HB, but it's always a good time down there. So check in the drive, Jen, on the southbound side. Oh, the 110, not a good time for you. Still in the South LA area. Exposition of Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. It is an ongoing fatality crash investigation. All southbound lanes of the 110 are shut down. Your drive is packed and tight as you're coming away from the 10. And then further southbound on the 110 is going to be a mess for your drive. Before Manchester, it's a crash that has the express lanes and the three left lanes are shut down. Looks like you're squeaking by on the right lane. That's why it's heavy for you on the 110 southbound Slauson as you make way toward Manchester. 405 south is an alternate. 710 south freeway-wise is an alternate. Those two are looking good to help save you a bit of time this morning. Surface street-wise, to the west of the 110, plan for western of Vermont. To the east of the 110, Main Street, San Pedro Street, or Central, they're all looking pretty good for the drive. If you're encountering otherwise, pound 250 on your cell phone keyword is KFI traffic. Southbound side of the 405, going to be a rough ride for you. A little bit of slowing as you make your way from Westminster into Huntington Beach. You'll see delays from before Golden West as you head toward Beach Boulevard. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
Hey, if you want to sell your house or condo fast and easy, you call Seller's Advantage. They're going to buy your home as is for cash. They're going to make you a cash offer within 24 hours. Whether your home is a total fixer-upper or in perfect condition, with Seller's Advantage, there aren't realtor fees or commissions, no escrow fees, no repairs will be needed, no open houses, no termite inspections, no hassles. If you want to sell your house fast and easy and get an as-is cash offer within 24 hours, you call Seller's Advantage. 888-321-AS-IS. Call 888-321-AS-IS or go to sellersadvantage.com. DRE number 01961658.
Big news! Greta Van Susteren is back, and she's on Newsmax. Tune into Newsmax at 6 p.m. Eastern tonight to watch The Record with Greta Van Susteren and get the real news. Plus, check out the new lineup of Rob Schmidt, Eric Bowling, and more. Newsmax is on all major cable and streaming platforms. If your cable system doesn't carry Newsmax, call them and demand it. And download the free Newsmax app on your phone. Make the switch to Newsmax today.
Guy and his cheap transmission fluid.
Seriously? My dealership just checked the brakes.
We all know how it can be to go to the wrong place for car repair. I can't believe the check engine light is on again. So don't risk it. Take your car to the experts at AMCO. AA, MCO. Check engine light on? We'll check it for free. Restrictions, limitations, and exclusions may apply. See AMCO.com for complete details.
This is Jacob Emrani. If you've been in an accident, call 844-24-JACOB.
SoCal weather from KFI. Perfect 4th of July weekend holiday weather. So it looks like temperatures are just going to be in the upper 60s, low 70s at the beaches. Mid to upper 70s for Orange County and Metro LA. Just the low to mid 80s for the valleys and the IE. Stay this way through most of the week, then we'll warm it back up into the 90s for the weekend. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee. This has been your wake-up call. Handle on the News with Wayne starts now.
Handle on the News.
Wayne World, Wayne World,
Network app. Good morning. Happy 4th of July. This is the Bill Handel Show. Bill on vacation. He hates America so much that he wanted to be in a foreign country for the 4th of July.
Oh, that's a good point.
Man, oh, man.
Well, Ms. Handel.
Do I have to say I'm kidding? Or is it, I mean, there'll be one person half listening going, hey, I heard Bill Handel hates America. Let's get that going on 4chan. Okay, listen, it's a holiday.
Woo!
And it's, you know, the teacher's not here.
Woo!
So it's going to be a little loose. I don't know what's going to happen. But if something's going to happen...
You roll out the TV with the old school VHS and make us take notes for the day?
Yeah, because that's what the substitute would do, remember
that? Oh, see, I don't feel like the substitute. I just feel like one of the kids in the class.
Oh, were you the kid
and
that,
literally,
like...
there's no teacher in the classroom right now.
Did you bring cupcakes?
Why do I have to bring the cupcakes? I'm just another kid in the class.
I brought breakfast this morning. You wouldn't like it, though, Wayne, because Wayne doesn't like eggs.
I don't.
And I made an egg bake, but it's really good. It has cheddar and ricotta and kielbasa and potatoes and milk and
most of those sound
powder.
Good. Most of those ingredients sound good, but you might as well say to me, it has all those things, and then I poured a quart of motor oil all over it. All right, let us begin the happy birthday, United States. Good morning.
Ta-da.
Good morning, Jennifer Jones Lee. Oh, you are wearing a patriotic
sweater.
Now,
take off your shoulder.
I don't want to call you out.
Oh, boy.
Because it's nobody's business.
Yeah.
If you want to moonlight and have another job on the side.
Okay.
However,
yeah.
Do you need to wear your work outfit from your other job to the station? Because clearly, ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Jones Lee moonlights as a patriotic flash dance cosplayer. For she is wearing a top that is blue with white stars on it, yet one side goes down over the shoulder with the tank top showing, the strap of the tank top, and all you need, I just would caution you, don't pull the... You see the chain there over your left shoulder? Don't pull it.
Oh, yeah.
Because the water that comes down will ruin the studio.
Hold on, you ready for this?
Yeah. And she's doing flash dance pose in the chair, everybody. That was a lot of time spent and wasted by me to just point out that the patriotic top you're wearing is of the... What do people who understand fashion call that look? Where one side is off the shoulder.
Off the shoulder. That's it. You literally nailed it. It's very 80s. It's very off the shoulder. Yeah, it's good. I learned how to archer. Archer? I learned to do archery.
Archery.
But what do you call that?
You learned archery.
I learned archery. And then I'm a what? I'm a beginner archer?
I don't know what the color belts are in archery.
I don't either, but I went, my friend Paul, who lives up in the Bay Area, he and a bunch of his buddies, got together and they rent out one of the cops have a campsite up there. Santa Clara County has like a big campsite in Saratoga. And he invited me to go up camping with his family and I tried archery. It's on JJLKFI. I'm sort of a badass. Not at all.
You with a bow and arrow.
It was fun, and I actually nailed it a few times, but then more often than not, I put the arrows in the ground.
At JJLKFI.
Also on there are pictures of Laura Ingle of KFI fame, Laura Ingle, who I got to see this weekend. It was a friend-filled weekend.
That's fantastic. All right, on to Tyler. Tyler, good morning and happy USA to you.
Good morning, Wayne, and happy USA to you.
And to you. I can't see what you're wearing, and so you're safe from my stupid comments about what you're wearing.
I have a blue off-the-shoulder sweater on with white stars on it.
Oh, so you copied Jennifer. And Alex is the luckiest of all, because she is producing, but she's running around somewhere. So she escapes all of this tomfoolery. Here we go. Handle on the news. Jennifer Jones Lee and me. Lead story.
Weather
going to be fantastic today in Southern California for the 4th of July. Warm, but not too hot. Sunny, not raining. And if the weather nerds are with me, you know, I know what you want to hear next, and I'm going to give it to you. The dew points will remain under 68 degrees today. What is the reason for saying that? That is the best way to get a sense of how comfortable you will be outside. I could give you temperature and I could give you relative humidity, but that simply doesn't tell the whole story. Dew point is the best number to know if you want to know. Are you going to shit or are you going to be comfortable? And if the dew points are staying under 60, which it looks like they are, and if the temperatures aren't going to get much past the mid-80s in the hottest parts of SoCal, then it should be extremely pleasant.
Perfect barbecue.
What does that prove? It proves God loves the United States of America.
Amen. God bless America, as I say. Thousands of flights have been canceled or delayed during this 4th of July weekend. Just Friday alone, more than 3,000 flights were canceled. Nearly 30,000 were delayed, according to FlightAware. I've got the recent numbers for you, and it looks CNBC says more than 12,000 American flights in July were canceled because they didn't have a captain, a first officer, or both because of a glitch in the scheduling software.
Ooh, we're going to talk about that later because of exactly what happened, what American has to do about it now, and also my crazy speculation.
Ooh.
About why it happened. Plus, the general, we're also going to get into just the general awfulness of how flying's going to be really bad for a while.
I have to say, I was nervous about this weekend. Everything went flawlessly. Burbank to Oakland, no delays, no nothing. It was great.
That's good. Hey, let's...